In this video, we will see how to represent a sentence and a word in our sequence model. So in the last class, we saw just an introduction to a sequence model. So let's first see what is a sentence and how we will represent it. So one training example represents one sentence. Like in the machine translation example, we have a sentence given in English and we will translate it to different language in Hindi. And in that sentence is made up of words. So sentence is this one complete example. This is just one example. We will have multiples of such sentences in English and multiple of sentences in Hindi on which we will train our sequence model. So within one training example, we will denote each of these words by this x1. So we denote input by x and output by y. So first word is x1. So this m we will denote by x2, then x3, all the way up to, so we have 3 to 5. So this is x4 and x5. Similarly, the output we will denote by, the output words will be denoted by y1, y2, and so on. So if this is our first example, that is, this is x1, so we denote ith training example by xi. So this denotes ith sentence in our training set. And each sentence has multiple words. So the first word in ith sentence we will denote by xi1. The second word would be xi2. And in general, for ith example, we will denote the tth word by t. So this will be our notation throughout the course. So here I is inside this small braces, so it will denote ith training sample, and this in this bracket we will denote the position of word, like this is first word, then second word, tth word. So this will be our example, and similarly for ith output we will denote tth word by this. So this will be our representation of words and sentences. Now, to denote the total number of words in a sentence, we will use this notation. So tx is equal to 5, because we have 5 words in this input sample, and output we have here 2, 4, 6. So ty is 6. Now let's see how we will represent each word. So for word representation, first we need a dictionary or a vocabulary. So we will have, for example, we have some standard English dictionaries, maybe of 50,000 words, or for practical purposes these can be even more. So each word would correspond to some position in the dictionary. For example, the words starting with letter A will take a lower position in the dictionary, because they come before the words that start with letter B, and so on. So first we need to come up with a dictionary. Then we will represent each word by one hot encoding. So what this means, we will see in the next slide. So one hot encoding basically is a representation of position of word in a vocabulary. So for word representation, we have some dictionary. So we have this huge dictionary where we have some word AA, then A, then let's say act, and a few other words, then some word starting with B, and so on. And let's say our last word in dictionary is zebra, and this is position 0. This is at position 1, and this is at position 50k minus 1, because we started from 0. So once we have defined our dictionary, if we want to represent this word act, what we will do, we will take one vector of length, column vector of 50,000 length, where this we will have third position as 1 and the rest others as 0. So this will be the representation of word act, and this is called one hot encoding, because we have just one position which is 1, rest others are 0. So this is called one hot encoding. So if I write I am learning machine learning, so here I, let's say in previous example I comes somewhere here, maybe around 18,000 mark, so we will represent this by all zeros, then some 1, and this one will be at position, let's say 18k, and A will be somewhere in the beginning, and then all others 0. So let's say this is at position 500. Similarly for learning and machine, and again learning. So this is this way we will represent each word using one hot encoding. So I have already given this example. So each word will correspond to one column vector, where one term will be 1, rest others will be 0. And this 1 will be at a position of word in dictionary. So I hope you understand how we will represent our words and sentences while training the sequence model. So thanks for watching.